Hey, this is Overpass Insights. My name is Eric, and today I want to ask a question. Does using existing libraries make you a bad developer? All right, so today I want to talk about a comment I got in last week on a video from Kirill. It's really good. Kirill says, "Hey Eric, have you ever thought about how good you are as a software developer?" Yeah, sometimes. I've been developing mobile apps for like 5 years, and most of the time I've been using existing solutions. Most of the time you just need to pull together known features, use common approaches, and popular libraries. That's more than enough to build a decent app and get paid. I'm not a talented programmer and not good in algorithms, but I can make an app and it will work good and will be written in a decent manner. But in fact, I'm just utilizing someone else's creations. For example, Android OS, it's a masterpiece of nowadays tech, or Android Studio or Flutter, or even the mobile device itself. Each of these are cutting edge of today's tech. The guys who are behind these software or hardware can't just Google their problem. Most of the problems are probably don't exist yet. Stack Overflow won't help. And if you think about it, it's pretty sad if you compare yourself with the guys who do the future. Have you ever thought about that? Kirill, yeah, I think about that all the time. And yeah, I don't compare myself to the guys of the future. And we are definitely, as mobile application developers, we are standing on the shoulders of giants. We are dealing with technology that someone else built. And a lot of times when we complain about, say, Google Play or Android as a platform or iOS as a platform, it is really the case where somebody else has built that and we're in their marketplace, which is different than if we were doing something completely from scratch. Right? But I think about this a lot. In fact, when I started as a software developer, it was a lot of VBA and Visual, which is Visual Basic for applications. Then I went to Visual Basic doing desktop applications. And one of the things that bothered me about Visual Basic was most Visual Basic apps look the same. You know, it was a square form, you know, text boxes, buttons, all that kind of stuff. And I remember talking to an instructor about this once. I said, "You don't have a lot of flexibility. You're not really building anything from scratch." And he said, "Well, that's true. Why would you want to do all the logic for a text box?" And for me, a text box is just like that's the lower part. He goes, "No, you got to have the on focus event. You would have, if you were to create a text box from scratch, all those things you would have to be put into it. So you're basically using a library or a framework that someone else had done." And as I start to go through my career, I started to see that more often than not. I mean, I've never been like a C++ programmer. I do things at that lower level. And I'm sure C++ developers probably think, "Oh, there's also people who do binary or whatever." So we're always building on a certain platform. And you're able to build creations based on things that other people have done. So we're almost like, I think about like chefs, like we're bringing in the right ingredients, right? We're bringing in things like a really good chef doesn't go out to the really low level and go out and kill the animal or harvest the vegetables, but they bring all the things in. And sometimes they might use pre-made solutions like butter or maybe even a packet of something. And you know, it depends on what level of chef they are. But in the end, the end user, the diner in a restaurant or the end user of our applications, they don't really notice the difference. It's something that us as software developers think about. So yeah, I definitely think, and this is where I talk about machine learning, right? When we talk about software programming, you know, I've always heard about how you have to be really, really good at math in order to be a good programmer. And I think you have to be decent at math, but I've never been really great at it. So I thought, but I've been possible. Like I'm using other people, say I could connect to a database, I could retrieve things. I understand how the concepts of software development work. And even the more advanced concepts like the design patterns and everything like that, kind of building upon that. But when it comes to like something like machine learning, that's where it was like, whoa, this is like really cutting edge stuff. And I tried to learn machine learning and I was really good to a certain point and it was like way over my head. So that was like testing the limits as being a software developer. But I don't think there's anything wrong with that. You could take existing libraries and always check the check to make sure the license is on them, make sure you're not using something that somebody could claim ownership to. if you're using something like that. But you're basically taking things that are already out there and building your own unique combinations with them. Ideally, they should be somewhat unique, right? You could do it for your clients, you do it for your users. The same way, if I go to the movies, I hear, you know, I see storylines that are like, you know, parts pulled from other things. There's nothing really very unique you see when you go see a movie. It's just like different constructs, different types of characters, different types of plot lines. Everything's kind of reused in different ways and different mashups of, and we're even the same with music. You know, how often have you heard a music that has a new note or using a brand new instrument? No, we're building on the things that other people have built before us. And unfortunately, yeah, I take what you mean about when we talk about Android or iOS, we are kind of at their mercy because it's always moving. They're always changing it. But we can still create great creations from it. I don't think there's anything wrong with it. And as a software developer, and a lot of software developers, we want to create things from scratch as much as possible. And sometimes it's a good idea, sometimes it's a bad idea. I've had contracts where the company says, we want to build this on top of SharePoint. And I'm like, I hate SharePoint. Let's not use SharePoint. Let's do it from scratch. And I'm trying to go the build it from scratch, which will be more expensive and will take us longer to test, all that kind of stuff. And you know, sometimes they went out, sometimes I do. Sometimes you're building something where you're just, you know, I've met SharePoint developers who don't even know how to code. They're called developers, but they just know the config of everything. So they're like at a different level than I am. And there's people who are C++ developers who could build anything probably, and they're at the lower end. And you know, yes, I do think about that from time to time. We are standing on the shoulders of giants. We are using the platforms that are there at our disposal. And I don't think there's anything wrong with that. I don't think it makes us less of developers. I suppose it's like being a man in the modern world where you go to the store and buy your stuff rather than go out and hunt. And there's guys out there who are way more masculine and manly than me, but you know, I'm doing pretty fine in the world that I am, that I live in, with the tools that I have. And I think it's kind of smart when you use a library rather than build something yourself. It doesn't say that you're less of a developer. It says that you're smart and you're resourceful. Just my thoughts on it. I thought it was a really good comment. Do I think I'm a really good programmer? I think I'm adequate. What do you guys think? Do you think you're a really good programmer? Do you think it makes you less of a developer because you use the libraries and the platforms that are there? It's a really good question. Something to think about. Anyway, hope you guys are having a great day. That's it for today. I'll talk to you next time.